So before we start anything, I just want to thank you guys for 50 subscribers. Like, that's kind of cool. I didn't really think we were going to even get past 5 subscribers, because those are all the people I told to subscribe to me. All 5 of my friends. Which kind of more friends than that, but they don't know I'm YouTube. Anyway, so just want to thank you guys. Like, that's really dope and awesome and cool that we got 50 subscribers. So, you know. Also, don't be alarmed by the title of this video. It's the last Wizard101 episode for now until May, because school is starting back up for me, and it's starting earlier because we're doing this weird thing. I don't know. So we don't have to take exams after Christmas. It's better so we can enjoy Christmas break. So, and I don't play Wizard101 during the school year because it costs membership to play, and, you know, no thanks. I'm not paying more money when I'm not going to be playing. Because I just don't have time. Like, I don't have homework and tests to study and whatever. So, but I will be posting Minecraft. So, yeah, that's, you know, cool. And also, one more thing. I promise we're going to play. It's not just going to be me talking. Also, there's apparently a massive update that just came out for this game. And this, the only thing I really care about is this really amazing. two things I care about. One thing is they made a new character, like a new NPC for, I think, someone who they have the Make-A-Wish thing for, you know, sick kids and stuff. They did a thing where this little kid, you know, I don't know all the details, but they made him an NPC of the character and a new boss battle. I don't have a high enough character, but I don't know, I think that's, you know, cute. So if you guys are high-level wizards, go check out whatever the new thing is. I think it's gonna be cool. Say a new thing is, let's see if we can find it. Okay, there's a new level 50 elixir. So, I don't know, this is apparently what this does is you take it, like you buy it, it's obviously a lot of money. You buy it and you use it, and it instantly makes your character level 50. So, you don't have to do any gameplay or anything, and it does all the quests, gives you all the spells, and gives you like new gear, mount. Obviously, it's really expensive, but I was thinking, basically, during Christmas, they do this thing in like 12 days. 12 days, I'll go in this guy. Oh, apparently I can't, never mind. So they do like this 12 days thing where we can get crowns. I mean, I got crowns last year, I didn't get a lot, but you can still get crowns from it, so it's really cool. So I was thinking, if I get enough crowns, I will make a new character, because obviously this is like where I'm doing the gameplay on this character, but I'll make a new character and do it and like just see what it is, and, you know, I started Celestia. It sends you right to Celestia. I started Celestia, and it's hard. So I mean, I wouldn't want to do Celestia again just for fun, because it's not fun. I haven't even finished it, but you know, just be cool to get that elixir and, you know, try it. So yeah, let's defeat the Harvest Lord. I don't know why. Let me press X, but we're going in now. Actually, wait. Let's see if there's anybody else who needs some help. No. Just gonna be long. Oh, never mind. So, just gonna wait 2 minutes. Don't worry, you guys won't have to wait. Oh my, so many people. You guys won't have to wait. I'll skip ahead. So, yeah, I'll see you guys when we're defeating the Harvest Lord.
The back of the room, you notice Archer, Susie's brother.
So, Wizard, you too have uncovered Malastare's plan. Too bad you will have to remain here with the other wizard. The both of you will be powerless to stop us.
Oh my god. So it looks like Susie's brother is alive, which, I mean, yay. I guess that's good. I don't know, like, no one really cared. This storyline's kind of stupid. Who cares about Susie's brother? Not about the cares. I don't care. Also, we're level 6, so I don't know if we're close to leveling up. Maybe we are. I don't know. I wasn't paying attention to my experience bar. But we need to level up soon so I can get more better, spells than just the ice beetle. Really embarrassing. Alright. Sorry, this music is so catchy. So, just, you know, let's just spam. Let's just spam the ice beetle. Well, he's fire, and we're ice. Oh, wait. Oh, wait, no. Okay, never mind. It's all good. I thought that was the shield he has on was a ice shield. Oh my god, they did so much damage. Actually, I'm running out of mana. I'm low, so that's not good. It's actually really bad. We have a full crew here. What's up? Everyone has better gear than me. It's kind of sad. I need better gear. I'll probably go shopping after this. Yeah, it does nothing to him. What the heck is the point? I think we're just gonna let these guys do all the work because we're just too weak. But it'll hopefully get us some experience. I didn't realize how low level we were though. We're only level 6. Alright. So, let's just attack some random dude. It doesn't matter. Oh, somebody fled? Boy, what you doing? Okay, well, we'll just let them attack the Harvest Lord. Because I'm weak, and I'll attack the other guys. Because Rotting Fodder is easy to defeat. Rapid silence. I don't really know what to talk about during battles. You just sit there and just click. It's like so fun, I know. Best game, 10 out of 10. Also, I'm going to be doing a video like right after this one, coming out like really soon after this one, because something crazy happened to me today, so I just want to tell you guys about that. I'm not going to spoil anything because it's really crazy, but, you know, just look forward to that. I don't understand what is going on. Well, we'll just keep spamming that one. Like, we're not doing any damage. Like, this is just sad. And then he's attacking me, obviously. We haven't even gotten our 2-pip spell yet. Like, what? We're fighting guys. 2-pip spells. We don't even have 2-pip spells. Like, what is this? Alright, that gets it. We're gonna kill that guy. Finish him off. You're welcome. We really need better gear, because this is just disappointing. No, I can't. Okay, is that guy dead? Oh, he's close enough. I'll attack that guy. You guys get that guy. Diana, come on, girlfriend. We got this. We got this. Come on. This better kill. Oh my god, I just didn't. Is that enough? No. I didn't realize that he had an ice shield. When did he get that? Like, boy. Come on, are you kidding? Okay, he's dead. Get out of here, sucker. Get out. Okay, 4 health. Great. Yeah, you're surviving. Totally. I'll watch him do a heal spell. I will cry. I will. Good. Oh, fizzle. Get out. Fizzle. Oh, I'm sorry. Storm people fizzle a lot in the beginning, though. I know, because I have a strong character and he's a strong one. Okay, defeated it.
Thank you for freeing me, my friend. I feared that no one was ever going to find me.
Oh, that's really
Please,
sad.
Go and tell my sister that I am safe. I know I have worried her so. May the winds of chance bring us together once more, wizard.
Let's try this thing on. Oh. Nice. Whatever, it gives me accuracy and something I don't even need. Actually, what the heck is the point? I don't even have any of those spells. We'll keep it on just because I feel like it'd be very annoying for you guys to see all the unmatching. So you're welcome. Hope you like it. Alright, let's go talk to Susie. Alright, Susie. We have good news.
You saved Arthur from the Harvest Lord? Thank you, young wizard. I don't know what I would have done had I lost him.
You would have just moved on eventually.
You'd better tell the headmaster what has happened here. He needs to be informed on what's happening in Wizard City.
Okay, we got a new cloak. Yes, it matches. Guys, oh my gosh, I'm so happy. That yellow one was actually kind of giving me a headache. It's so ugly, but yay, we got one for beautiful iciness. I don't really want to know what that is. Let's see. Okay, it gives us resistance in ice, which is good. Yay. Because we didn't really need accuracy in, what was it? I don't even remember. Oh yeah, myth. We didn't need that because you don't have any myth spells. It's like pointless, so whatever. We could sell that later for some money. But I'll go see you guys when I get to Merle Ambrose. Alright, Merle, I don't know. We have some news for you. Not too sure what we're supposed to be telling you, but whatever, let's go.
By Bartleby, you defeated the Harvest Lord?
Yes.
Oh, not many students can make that claim. Good work, young wizard.
Thank you.
The Harvest Lord mentioned that he was helping Malastare. We need to find out what Malastare's plans are, if Wizard City is ever to return to the nice place it once was. It's hard to run a school with all the monsters running amok. Many thanks to you for straightening everything out on Triton Avenue, young wizard. I fear the worst is not over yet. I want you to introduce yourself to Diego, the Duel Master. The arena is just inside the entrance to Unicorn Way, on the right.
We're gonna go talk to Diego. I feel like the last episode I hyped up for this boss battle, and it was really anticlimactic, and now we're just probably gonna be talking to just random people for the rest of the episode. I don't know, though. I don't remember what we do. It's been so long since I actually played this quest. The Wizard City quest line, so I don't know.
Right. Greetings. My name is Diego Santiago Corriquez Ramirez III, champion duelist.
Hello.
The duel master bows with a great flourish of his cape.
The arena is a wondrous place. Students come here to hone their skills with magic, practice against others, and gain endless glory and fame. To try your hand against your classmates, enter the arena and step into the... If you train well, perhaps you can develop skills to rival... What a duelist he was! He's the only person I would not want to duel in a real fight. Luckily, we only sparred for practice. Speaking of Malastare, did you know that he and Cyrus are twin brothers? I wouldn't be surprised if Cyrus... You should tell Ambrose to keep an eye on Cyrus.
Alright, that was actually pointless, but whatever. Let's go back to Merle Ambrose.
Diego thinks that Cyrus is helping Malastare cause all this trouble on Wizard City, eh? Oh, Diego shouldn't be spreading foolish rumors. Cyrus is a good professor. I trust him completely. I'm sure you heard that Malastare Drake used to teach at the Death School. He was once one of our best professors, very powerful and compassionate. He loved discovering secrets of power. The only thing he loved more than power was his wife, Sylvia. May she rest in peace. If only she was still with us, things might be different. But even death cannot be undone. Speaking of issues concerning Malastare, one of his favorite students, a boy named Duncan Grimwater, has been tackling a ghost problem over on Triton Avenue. Can you inquire as to whether he has heard anything from his old professor? We need to know if Malastare has been contacting former students.
Why does this sound like something else? Why does this sound like Harry Potter? Because, and just let me nerd out for a second, but Harry Potter, in the movies and books, everyone's like, oh, don't trust Snape, and, you know, and nobody trusted him, and Harry Potter thought that, you know, he was trying to kill him, and Dumbledore's like, yeah, no, I trust him, like, he's dope and whatever, and then, you know, he was cool at the end, so that's what happens. I'm gonna spoil the ending of this first arc, basically, once you finish Dragonspire. Cyrus helps you defeat Malastare. Not really, though. He's not much of a help, but whatever. You know, he helps you out, and he's good in the end, so nobody trusts Cyrus right now. But you guys just wait, you know. It's all good. He's pretty, you know, chill. And, you know, guys, everyone needs to stop being so mean to him. Like, I feel bad. Like, Diego, come on. Stop spreading these rumors. Like, just stop, dude. And now I was gonna talk to Duncan Grimwater, and I hate him. He's so mean. Get out.
So, the headmaster's still worried about Malastare. You ask me, I think Ambrose needs to quit blaming Malastare every time something goes wrong in Wizard City. Malastare Drake was such an inspiring professor. Most consider him to be the greatest necromancer of our time. He understood life's limitations and strove to face them unafraid. Ambrose has suggested for me to stop practicing the death arts. He even suggested I give life a try. Ha! But I keep studying on my own. Maybe one day I will be as powerful as Malastare.
No, get out.
If you want to find out more about Malastare, maybe you should talk to an old friend of his wife. You have heard what happened to Malastare's wife, right?
Yes, we have.
No? Oh, if you're interested, go talk to Gloria Crindle in Old Town and ask her about Sylvia Drake. Those two women were close. She could tell you more.
Why is this a mandatory questline? I don't care. Yes, okay, we get it. She died and Malister's angry. Okay, now let's get to the fighting. Like, nobody wants to know how she died. I know how she died. She got sick. I already know. She got sick and then they couldn't heal her. Even though it doesn't make any sense. She got really sick and they couldn't heal her, but she was the life teacher. Like, does that make any sense to you? Because it doesn't make sense to me. Like, she should be on top of everything, you know. Oh, I'm sick, boom, life potion or whatever. Like, why did you die from getting sick? I don't understand. It's just stupid. It does not make any sense.
You want to ask me about Malister's wife, Sylvia? Oh my, yes. I knew her very well. She taught the life magic class before Mulinda Wu.
Okay, this is, before we continue, this woman's voice is just terrifying. Like, this is like what nightmares, like, hello, I am Gloria Grendel. Like, no, what the heck? That's not normal.
I sure miss her. Stop. What happened to her was such a shame, poor dear.
Madame Grendel becomes forlorn as she relives the sad memories.
Say, there is something you can do for me, child. Would you go find the scrapbook Sylvia and I made together? It would mean a lot to me to have it back. I'm not sure how, but Sergeant Skullsplitter has it. Could you go to his tower on Triton Avenue and get it back for me?
But I don't have... What the heck? Ooh, they changed the interface. Oh, interesting. That's new. Cool. So we're fighting another boss, but we have, like, terrible spells. Like, did we get anything new? No, we just have... Oh, we just have this garbage. Like, this is not really fair. I think we get a new spell, like, what, level 8? I don't know. I'm going on a limb. I thought it was level 6. But that, you know, that didn't happen. We're level 7 now. Where are we going? I'm going the wrong way. Alright, I'll catch you guys at Sergeant Skull Splitter's tower or whatever.
So, you've come for the scrapbook that belonged to Malister's wife, eh? Pity. Well, I won't allow you to have it. I will deny him any kindness after what he denied me in life. As for you, wizard, prepare to join the ranks of the undead and serve me.
Okay, so basically, I didn't have any time to be like, okay, we're here at the tower, because I clicked team up and I was gonna do the intro, whatever, you know, as I was waiting for the team up, and then I just immediately get sent into battle. And what level is this dude? Excuse me. I'm clicking furiously, and I can't, it's not coming up. Whatever, we'll figure it out. Because he looks like he's in Mushu at the moment. Mushu or Marleybone, which is after Naruto. You guys probably have no idea what I'm saying. I'm using all this cryptic language, but those are worlds. Yeah, he's like really high level. Boy. Actually, no, that's good, because then he's gonna kill everyone for us. Yeah, see? Easy. Didn't even need to join. We'll figure out what level he is. I like his pet though. Yeah, see, everyone's dead. That was easy. Alright, we're done here, guys. Thanks. I think these are two are together. Alright, let's figure out this guy's level before we do anything else. Come here, bro. Inspect. 39. This is all weird. I don't know. Alright. Okay. Alright. Alright, so now we're gonna go talk to Glory. I should have just left the marker at her, honestly. Because now I have to do some more walking, and I do not. I don't have to do walking. My mount does. I'll catch you guys at Gloria. Alright, Gloria, here's your scrapbook.
You were able to get the scrapbook from Sergeant Skullsplitter?
Yep.
Oh, good. I was so afraid it was lost forever. It contains all my memories of Sylvia.
Because you're too old to remember anything else.
Madame Grendel begins to thumb through the old scrapbook.
Now let's see. Ah, yes. Sylvia had such a wonderful laugh.
It was so sad when she got sick.
Told you, she got sick.
She got a nasty cold and wouldn't get better. They tried everything to heal her, but nothing worked. Imagine the greatest life professor being struck down like that.
I don't think you can die from just a nasty cold. Like,
she was dying and that was that. Poor Malastare couldn't stand it. It broke his heart having to let her go. He was never the same afterwards. He withdrew from his colleagues, even from his brother, Cyrus.
Oh, no.
Well, thanks for bringing the scrapbook back to me, child. I am forever grateful.
You're welcome. Got a hat. Let's try it on. Oh, it's snazzy looking. Doesn't really match our shoes, but matches our robe. We'll wear it. I think it gives us some cool benefits. Yep. Does it give us more or less? This one is better? What? Because it gives us defense. Yeah, buddy. Okay. Yes. Yes. Okay. I don't know what they're talking about. Okay, sorry. I really wanted to. I don't know. Where are we going? What are we doing, huh? What are we supposed to be? Now what? What are we doing? Was that it? Well, I'm just gonna go talk to Ambrose, because I don't really know what we're supposed to be doing.
Brewed up this potion especially for Bartleby, the tree in the center of Ravenwood. He hasn't been feeling well lately. He has trouble remembering things since his eye was stolen.
The headmaster gives you a bottle with a bubbling blue elixir inside.
Take the potion over to Bartleby and see what happens. Take note of anything he says.
Alright, so I wanted to say, I talked to Ambrose. And, you know, he just gave me this potion. So I'm thinking that we can't move on with the main quest until we get to level 8. But before we go help Bartleby, I'm just going to go check out Duncan real quick to see if he wanted us to talk to him after Gloria. So I'll talk to you guys either when I get there or, you know, when we're talking to Bartleby. So Duncan had nothing to say to me, so I guess we're just going to be helping Bartleby out. I don't really know, like, anything else what the main quest line we're supposed to do after this. But if you look over on the left, there's his missing eye. Another one. He has an eye. Like, how do you steal an eye, though? Like, what the heck? Oh, his name's just Twitch. All right, let's talk to him.
Must hold on to the first world until... Oh, it's so hard for me to remember things. My mind is not as clear as it once was.
You pour the headmaster's potion all around Bartleby's roots.
Ah, that's good.
Bartleby looks off into the distance and speaks in deep, hollow tones.
Beware, Master Ambrose. Beware of Malastare. He comes at night to torment me. Find the one who can defeat him. That one is the savior of Wizard City.
Well, that's so flattering, Bartleby. I'm glad that you think I can save Wizard City. That really means a lot to me. We only have to go through 5 worlds. 5 worlds to save just Wizard City. So fun.
So that's what Bartleby had to say. My, how odd. Not the outcome I was quite expecting.
Headmaster Ambrose scratches his head, thinking.
Bartleby used to have 2 eyes. Gifts from his sister, Lady Nightstar, the grandmother of ravens. They were called the Eyes of Time. One showed the past, and the other the future. Recently, Malastare stole the Eye of History. Now, Bartleby can't remember things. I will have to think upon Bartleby's words about Malastare. Things are so dire. I must be sure to choose wisely. There will be no second chances. Have you had a chance to visit the new pet pavilion in the comp? Please convey this item to Ringmaster Barker. Post haste. He shall reward you handsomely for your efforts.
I'm not too sure what we're supposed to do now. I helped Bartleby. Don't really want to do the pet quest line. feel like we're gonna have to. I don't know, I'll figure it out. So when we come back, when I catch you guys back in May, or whenever, sometime after that, maybe, I'll have, like, everything planned out, and I'll know exactly what I'm supposed to be doing. But for now, thank you guys very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Sad to say, this is the last episode for now of Wizard101. But, I might do some specials here. Oh, my. I might do some specials here and there. But other than that, I don't know. See you guys later. Stay tuned for Minecraft stuff, because, gonna be posting a lot of that. Anyway, guys, thank you very much for watching. Subscribe if you're new to Dren Teasy Nation. I'll see you guys later. Goodbye.